वेलकम टू ऑल माय डियर भैया बहन इन टुडेज क्लास. टुडे वी आर अगेन गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द सेकेंड चैप्टर दैट इज ए टाइगर किंग. वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट टुडे सेकेंड पार्ट फ्रॉम क्राउन प्रिंस जंग जंग बहादुर ग्रीव टॉलर एंड स्ट्रॉन्गर डे बाई डे. No other miracle marked his childhood days apart from the event already described. Before expressing second part, I would like to ask you some questions related to first part. Question from you, who was the Tiger King? Very good. The Tiger King was the king of Pratibandhapuram state. Why was his name was the Tiger King? Very good. Because he had killed 99 tigers. What was his original name? Very good. Jang Jang Bahadur. Okay, now we should start the next part and the first paragraph. Crown Prince Jang Jang Bahadur grew taller and stronger day by day. No other miracle marked his childhood days apart from the event already described. In this paragraph, we see the crown prince Jang Jang Bahadur grew taller and stronger as the days passed by. There were no other miracles in his childhood. The boy drank the milk of an English cow, was brought up by an English nanny, tutored in English by an English man, saw nothing but English films. Exactly as the crown princes of all the other Indian states did. When he came of age at 20, the state which had been with the court of wards until then came into his hands. Here we see, as a boy, he drank the milk of an English cow. Was brought up by an English governess, got lessons in English by an English man, and watched English films just like the crown princes of other Indian states did. When the crown prince Jang Jang Bahadur turned 20 years of age, the royal estate, which had been in the custody of the court of wards, was given to him. Here, court of wards means the court of wards was a legal body created by the East India Company. Its purpose was to protect heirs and their estates when the heir was deemed to be a minor and therefore incapable of acting independently. Now, write down some meanings here. Conclude means decide. Marked means influenced. Apart means besides. Brought up means upbringing. Nanny, a woman who takes care of young children. In Hindi it is called aya, or you can say dai. Tutored means taught. Came of age means grew up. Court of wards, a child who is under legal protection. Now see the next paragraph. But everyone in the kingdom remembered the astrologer's prediction. Many continued to discuss the matter. Slowly it came to the Maharaja's ears. Here we see, all the people who lived in the kingdom were aware of the astrologer's prediction. many of the people discussed these predictions, and one day King Jang Jang Bahadur came to know of it. Means when King Bahadur became young, he heard that people were talking about him. People were talking about astrologers' prediction about him, and slowly and gradually Maharaja came to know about him, what the astrologers predicted about him. There were innumerable forests in Pratibandhpuram state. They had tigers in them. The Maharaja knew the old saying, "You may kill even a cow in self-defense." There could certainly be no objection to killing tigers in self-defense. The Maharaja started out on a tiger hunt. And we all know that Maharaja was the king of Pratibandhpuram state. And this state had many forests which had a number of tigers in them. The Maharaja was aware of an old saying that you could kill even a cow in order to protect yourself. So he felt that the cow, which was considered to be a holy animal, could also be killed by a Hindu in order to save himself. Then no one would object if he killed a tiger in order to protect himself. So Maharaja Jang Jang Bahadur started out on a tiger hunting expedition. The Maharaja was thrilled beyond measure when he killed his first tiger. He sent for the state astrologer and showed him the dead beast. In this way, Maharaja started killing tigers one by one. Maharaja was very excited when he killed the first tiger. He called for the state astrologer and showed him the dead beast. Maharaja said to the astrologer, "What do you say now?" he demanded. Here he stands for the tiger king. "Your majesty may kill 99 tigers in exactly the same manner." But the astrologer drawled, "But what? Speak without fear. But you must be very careful with the 100th tiger. What if the 100th tiger were also killed?" There is a discussion between Maharaja and the astrologer. What is the discussion? See here. The king asked the astrologer for his comments, and the astrologer replied that the king could kill 99 tigers in exactly the same way as he had killed the first one, and he stopped speaking. The king encouraged the astrologer to continue without fear. So the astrologer said that the king had to be very careful with the 100th tiger that he hunted. The king asked him that what would happen if he killed the 100th tiger also. When Maharaja told the astrologers that if he will be able to kill 100 tiger, what will he do then? The astrologer said, "Then I will tear up all my books on astrology, set fire to them, and what? I shall cut off my tuft, crop my hair short, and become an insurance agent." The astrologer finished on an incoherent note. This is the speech of astrologer. The astrologer replied that he would tear all his books of astrology and set them on fire. He continued that he shall cut off his hair and would change his profession from an astrologer to an insurance agent, as he would not remain a good astrologer any longer. See the reply of astrologer. Astrologer said, if I am fail in my astrology, he will tear his all books of astrology. He will set fire on them. And he also told, he will cut off his hair and he will change his profession from astrologer to an insurance agent. Now write down some meanings here. Innumerable means numberless. Self-defense means to defend oneself. It is called Atmaraksha. Thrilled means overjoyed. Beast means wild animal. Drawled means spoke slowly. Tuft means bunch of hair. Crop means haircut. Incoherent means unable to express clearly. Note means sound. Onwards means now on. Now see the next paragraph. We are going to start third part. From that day onwards, it was celebration time for all the tigers inhabiting Pratibandhapuram. The state banned tiger hunting by anyone except the Maharaja. A proclamation was issued to the effect that if anyone dared to fling so much as a stone at a tiger, all his wealth and property would be confiscated. What happens in this paragraph? You see, from that day, the tigers in Pratibandhapuram had a nice time as the kingdom banned tiger hunting by anyone except the Maharaja. No one was allowed to kill a tiger other than the Maharaja himself. The law was so strict that an official announcement was made that if anyone was caught killing a tiger or even throwing a stone at a tiger, his wealth and property would be taken away by the kingdom of Pratibandhapuram. You must have seen here something. The tiger king banned tiger hunting in Pratibandhapuram, except himself. Why? Because he knew if any other person will kill any tiger, then he will be unable to complete the killing of 100 tigers. So that he banned tiger killing in his kingdom, and he announced if anyone will be caught killing a tiger or even throwing a stone at a tiger, his wealth and property would be taken away by the kingdom of Pratibandhapuram. Means the king made strict rule there. The king made strict law there. And in this way, tiger killing was banned in Pratibandhapuram by other person. Now write down meanings here. Inhabiting means dwelling. Banned means stopped by law. Proclamation means announcement. Issued means announced. Confiscated means seized. Initially means in the beginning. Now next. The Maharaja vowed he would attend to all other matters only after killing the 100 tigers. Initially, the king seemed well set to realize his ambition. Maharaja wanted to finish killing 100 tigers. What did he do? The king of Pratibandhapuram took an oath that he would attend to all other matters of the kingdom only after he had killed 100 tigers. Means he stopped taking interest in other matters of the kingdom except killing 100 tigers. In the beginning, it seems that he would achieve his target very fast. Now, next paragraph, not that he faced no dangers. There were times when the bullet missed its mark. The tiger leaped upon him and he fought the beast with his bare hands. Each time it was the Maharaja who won. When Maharaja started killing tigers, sometimes Maharaja faced dangers also. It was not that he feared the tiger. When the king went on his hunting expeditions, he faced danger many times. At times, his bullet missed its target and the tiger jumped upon him. The tiger would fight with tigers barehanded, but each time he won and killed the tiger. Now write the meaning here. Well set means established. Realize means fulfill. Ambition means aim or desire. Bullet, a small object fired from the gun. Mark means aim. Bare means empty. Next paragraph. At another time, he was in danger of losing his throne. This paragraph is very important. See this paragraph very seriously. At another time, he was in danger of losing his throne. A high-ranking British officer visited Pratibandhapuram. He was very fond of hunting tigers and fonder of being photographed with the tigers he had shot. As usual, he wished to hunt tigers in Pratibandhapuram, but the Maharaja was firm in his resolve. He refused permission. I can organize any other hunt. You may go on a boar hunt. You may conduct a mouse hunt. We are ready for a mosquito hunt. But tiger hunt, that's impossible. See, my dear, what the Tiger King told in this paragraph. Here we see that writer tells us another instance when King Jang Jang Bahadur was about to lose his throne. Throne means Raj Gaddi, you can say. A high-ranking British officer visited Pratibandhapuram once. He was fond of hunting tigers and he wanted to get himself photographed with the dead tigers. He wanted to hunt tigers in Pratibandhapuram also. But as the Maharaja had banned killing tigers by any other person, he did not give permission to this British official also. He offered him to go on any other hunting, like mouse or even a mosquito hunt, but he refused to arrange a tiger hunting for this British officer. Now write down meaning. Fonder means fond of. Resolve means determination. Boar hunt means hunting wild pigs. You can say jungli suar ka shikar. In this paragraph we have seen, when British officer came to Pratibandhapuram for hunting of the Tiger King stopped him for this. Because he made a law there, nobody can kill tiger except him. But British officer was very much fond of hunting tigers and he also wanted to be photographed with the dead tigers. But the tiger king told him, the tiger king offered him to go on any other hunting like mouse, like boar, like mosquito, or any other hunting except tiger hunting. In this way, the throne of the king became in trouble. In this way, the king became in trouble after neglecting British officers. See next paragraph. The British officer secretary sent word to the Maharaja through the Diwan that the Durai himself did not have to kill the tiger. The Maharaja could do the actual killing. What was important to the Durai was a photograph of himself holding the gun and standing over the tiger's carcass. But the Maharaja would not agree even to this proposal. If he relented now, what would he do if other British officers turned up for tiger hunts? Here, you see again a word you see here, Durai. Here, Durai is a Tamil word meaning chief or leader. Next word is carcass, means the dead body of an animal. Relented, relaxed his decision. What happened in this paragraph? See here. The British official's secretary sent a message to the Maharaja that the Durai, that is the official himself, did not want to kill the tiger. The king could kill the tiger, he only wanted to get himself photographed with the dead body of a tiger. But the king did not agree to this proposal also. He said that if he relaxed his decision and allowed the official to get himself photographed with the dead tiger, then other British officers would also come to Pratibandhapuram in order to fulfill their wish of hunting a tiger. In this way, Maharaja stopped giving any kinds of opportunity to the British officers to be photographed with dead tiger. In this way, the king became in trouble, his throne became in trouble, and his throne was going to be lost. How did he save his throne? See this paragraph here. Because he prevented a British officer from fulfilling his desire, the Maharaja stood in danger of losing his kingdom itself. The Maharaja and the Diwan held deliberations over this issue. As a result, a telegram was dispatched forthwith to a famous British company of jewelers in Calcutta. Send samples of expensive diamond rings of different designs. See, my dear, the king started to give bribe to the British officers to save his throne. What did he do? See here. As the king had refused a British officer from fulfilling his wish, he was in danger of losing his kingdom. It is very important question here. How once Maharaja was going to lose his kingdom and how he saved his kingdom. The king had discussions with his minister over this issue. The king sent a telegram to a famous British company of jewelers based in Calcutta. He asked them to send samples of expensive diamond rings of different designs. After giving orders, some 50 rings arrived. The Maharaja sent the whole lot to the British officer's good lady. The king and the minister expected to Durasani टू चूज वन और टू रिंग्स एंड सेंड द रेस्ट बैक विद इन नो टाइम एट ऑल द दुरासनी सेंट हर रिप्लाई थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर योर गिफ्ट्स. हियर दुरासनी मीन्स तमिल वर्ड फॉर वाइफ ऑफ द चीफ. इन टू डेज ए बिल फॉर 3 lakh ऑफ रुपीज केम फ्रॉम द ब्रिटिश ज्वेलर्स. द महाराजा वॉज हैप्पी दैट दो ही हैड लॉस्ट 3 lakh ऑफ रुपीज ही हैड मैनेज टू रिटेन हिज किंगडम. What happened here to save his kingdom? The king bribed his wife 50 golden rings. The king thought here, the wife of British officer should keep 1 or 2 rings, but that lady kept all those rings. And the price of all those 50 rings were 3 lakhs. The jeweler sent 50 rings and the Maharaja sent all of them to the British officer's wife. He wanted to please her in order to make good the damage that he had done by refusing the official from going on a tiger hunt in his kingdom. The king had expected that the British officer's wife would choose 1 or 2 rings and return the others, but she just sent a reply saying thanks for the gifts and she kept all the rings. After 2 days, the British jewelers sent a bill of 3 lakh rupees for the 50 diamond rings they had sent. The Maharaja was happy that he had saved his kingdom for a sum of 3 lakh rupees. My dear, bribery is not new. Corruption is not new. Corruption is old. Corruption is coming from the beginning of this earth. Bribery is coming from the beginning of this earth. The king saved his kingdom by giving 50 gold rings to the wife of British officer. Such thing happens today also. We know it. We know it by media. But in the old days, we didn't know that because media was not available. Today, media is strong. You must have seen, if anybody takes bribe, media is there to send him jail. In these days, there are so many cameras to take photographs of the man who is doing corruption. So, this corruption is from the beginning of this earth. We are not aloof from this. So today we shall stop here and next day we shall start from 4th part. Now write down some meanings from the above paragraph. Write down. Deliberations means discussions. Issue means matter. Dispatched means sent. Forthwith means at once. Samples means specimen. Expensive means costly. Lot means share. Managed means succeeded. Retain, keep safe. Unforeseen, means not seen before. Hurdle, means obstacle. Now, we shall read part 4 on the next day. You will prepare homework from these paragraphs. in textbook also. So till then, thank you, have a nice day.